And we are here, ladies and gentlemen, for the main event of the evening. And there's no question this should be a real slobber knocker. Two of the best to ever do it, I've got to say. Silver Viper, who's his birthday is today, folks. I guess you can wish him a happy birthday. What is he, 80 years old now?
40. Looks good for his age. Will you relax?
You know, 40 is the new 80. It's all the rage these days. But nevertheless, Shawn Michaels, the Heartbreak Kid, one of the greatest in-ring performers that this sport, this business has ever seen, going against Silver Viper, who takes a lot of his repertoire and his general aesthetic, if you will, from this man's rival. And they tore it up in the 90s. And I'm pretty sure, folks, there's no hyperbole, they're going to tear it up here in Las Vegas, Nevada. The rest of the program is theirs. They can go until the lights are all out in this arena, and I can't wait. Personally, myself, I am excited to see this matchup.
Well, I am too. I most certainly am, as we are set here in the main event, the Viper's birthday. It is his night. Last year on his birthday, he was fighting independent tag titles with Red Rock, and now, that's a new song. First time seeing the man since Survivor Series. And there, whoa, there the man is. It is Friday the 13th, isn't it? There he is. Silver Viper, this Friday the 13th in fashion. Right to the ring.
Well then, Silver Viper playing the part. Perhaps looking to kill, so to speak, Shawn Michaels' dreams of ever defeating him in a one-on-one matchup. But Michaels is not moved. At least he doesn't look like it. I mean, hell, he's faced Vader. Vader was a big, scary guy. You know, someone would liken him to Jason. He was pretty much invulnerable. And Silver Viper is no Vader, for better or for worse.
Find out just what Viper. Whoa, look at that. Look at that. That light the candles, I guess. Viper, as you said, he takes the repertoire from HBK's bitter rival. It patches up, so what? But we know that there is, you know, there's going to be something Shawn feels, some bit of familiarity in the ring, perhaps. And maybe Shawn's hoping to use that to his advantage. Shawn's hoping that, you know, he studied the tape of Viper. He studied that Shawn has been in the ring with this man's son, actually. You know, being a prodigy, seeing what he's trained. And now to face the master himself, one-on-one. Last time Shawn Michaels was out here on SmackDown, it was against Undisputed, where the Heartbreak Kid showed he can still go and is in some of the best shape ever have been. Off the ropes. Ew!
Back body drop. 12-6 elbows right down to the top of the head by Michaels.
And call it right down the middle, okay? How do you feel? Who do you think is walking out of here with a victory?
Cool. I mean, there's a lot of things that I can do here at this commentary table. We'll put bets on two stallions is something I would never do.
Oh, it's Vegas. You have to do it. Here off the... Oh!
Atomic drop by Michaels. And this here, folks, is a classic Michaels sequence. But Silver Viper just got up in that body drop.
Shawn
that body
Michaels,
said, drop down.
Expect, you know, again, Silver, having grown up watching the Heartbreak Kid, having seen the Heartbreak Kid, you know, kicked in the back section, having only ever met him once backstage in a WWE tryout back in late 2009. And there, the crossface. Elbow to the face. Elbow to Shawn Silver Viper.
Michaels. Well, see, the thing about Michaels and you know, guys like Michaels in general, is you often know what's coming. You can't do anything to stop it. I mean, that sweet chin music, you know, when he tunes up the band, you hear the crowd, they sing along, they do whatever. But once that Michaels boot comes flying at you, you don't know what hit you. That's what Silver Viper has to deal with. He has to deal with that lightning fast kick of Shawn Michaels that has won him multiple world championships, that won him the Elimination Chamber.
And here, slow to the feet. Down.
Viper back up goes Michaels. The same thing is said for Silver Viper and his patented Widowmaker, his orphan's cradle. He has every tool he needs in the shed. Off the ropes, Michaels.
Viper doing a phenomenal job of grinding Michaels. I was about to say, you know, what's interesting, Michaels is an accomplished catch-as-catch-can wrestler, not necessarily an amateur wrestler in any regard. But he does have the fundamentals, the basics of this sport intact. That's what makes Michaels one of the best. And now, look at that. That's exactly what I'm talking about. A fisherman suplex. Silver Viper might take a break here. Smart man going outside the rope.
Here comes Michaels.
And HVK following Silver Viper out into the ropes. And again, folks, this is our main event. Silver Viper on his birthday, 40th birthday, not 80th, as was cleared up in the beginnings of this matchup, against the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
No, my way!
Who has been very game, maybe up until this moment. And it's no secret that Michaels has had a history of back problems. I mean, that's why he retired back during the peak of the Attitude Era, is because those spinal problems. And Silver Viper now taking advantage in full regard.
And Shawn in trouble. Viper breaking the count. No, I just a light to the man. He's dressed up as Viper is getting real brutal. He could have slid Michaels back in to the ring already, but he's getting something to go outside. And Shawn kicked up and told the man.
Sweet kid music. Sweet kid music. Silver Viper just got knocked out cold. And both men are down.
Did he though? Did he?
Oh, wow. I can't believe my eyes right now.
The man primed on his 40th birthday, kicked out of Sweet Chin, or kicked up from Sweet Chin, quicker than most young men in their primes. Oh! Down off the double axe handle. Right hand. Two-time world champion, former Intercontinental champion, going to work. Michael scoots off the table before the danger. Oh, man. Oh!
And again, the smaller the back for Michaels. You can see him clutching it there. He's not trying to hide it. Or at least he can't anymore. The pain is too much to bear, perhaps. Silver Viper recognizes it. Sword arm scissors, it looks like. Extending the shoulder socket, trying to neutralize any of the strength that Michaels can possess in this matchup.
Count still to six. Here comes Viper swinging Michaels into the barricade. Swing, miss. This is a lightning fast. Ooh. This is a game of chess, human chess. Scoop around right under the knee.
And we are about closing in on 10 minutes or so of this matchup. And look, you see right there, Silver Viper again trying to attack the arms of Michaels. We still don't have a clear, you know, leader in this matchup. It's been pretty much a stalemate, but Michaels is throwing
Sweet
that haymaker, and he gets it. Sweet Chin music. Now in the middle of the ring, he could go for the cover here.
The
damage done to the back.
They want one more, but Shawn, as you said it, yeah, the damage was indeed done. Viper in trouble.
Can he even produce one more is the question.
Oh, can he? He's going to have to, because Silver Viper just kicked back up. Slow, right there, off the ropes. Viper, out the way. Only catch.
And I haven't known Shawn Michaels ever be a man who has a will that can be faltered, but that had to be demoralizing right there. Kick out of the Sweet Chin music. But what's Michael thinking now? HBK's going to fly. Oh, no. No.
And Viper to the Vegas crowd saying hello, so getting the greetings in. Whoa. Whoa.
And Silver Viper with a springboard of his own. And that time it lands.
Shawn has to be a little bit delirious now. He is in the grips of hell. Off the ropes. Down he missed.
And tried the elbow drop. Michaels had the sense. You know, if that elbow hit the small of the back,
bulldog.
The part of Michael's body that is most vulnerable here, it might have been the end of the match. It might have been the end of his career.
Scooped up off the ropes. Big crossbody. And again, Silver Viper. Oh, small package.
Nice roll up. We saw a small package, excuse me, schoolboy, early in the match, early in this night.
Leg drop.
And it could have been a 2 for 2, but Michaels being able to kick out of that, it helps his momentum here in this matchup. But Silver Viper is now far and away become the man with the most offense. And now, this might be his last piece of offense, the Widowmaker.
And Sean, you know how that ended for him last time. He's on and not out of it.
Kick Shawn right Michaels, he perhaps knows the sharpshooter maneuver like the back of his own hand at this point.
Went for the big sweet chin. Not to be. Viper stopped it. Viper stopped sweet chin.
Right in to Michaels. Goodness. And Silver Viper hits what he's got to hit from this top rope. It might be over. And Michaels senses that his back cannot take that amount of damage.
Ooh, went for the bold.
A little bit of miscalculation by Michaels. But now, like I said earlier, he's tuning up the band. Las Vegas, Nevada has come alive. Sweet chin. Oh, Silver Viper catches the boot. Shoots the double leg. Widowmaker
applies. On their feet. Viper, Widowmaker locked in. Happy birthday, Silver.
Las Vegas has reached a fever pitch as Silver Viper taps out the Heartbreak Kid with a patented maneuver of his own, the Widowmaker. It's a little different from a sharpshooter, folks. It's because Silver Viper is applying it. And you can see it right there. Tighter than an anaconda vice's hold.
Happy birthday to Viper. I think that's a beautiful way to end it. No!
Whoa!
No! What? Have mercy! He's here! Who the hell?
Who let him in?
Viper's trying to fight back, but he just wrestled a full match! Hollywood, is it? No!
What the hell is Hollywood Hulk Hogan doing out here?
And look at this. The rights, Silver Viper's still fighting back. Again, the man just wrestled a 10-plus minute match, still on his feet, as this coward tries to take the air out of his birthday. The man was celebrating, damn you.
The Hulkster, who Silver Viper has been very vocal about his disdain for, is now squaring up with Silver Viper after he wrestled a true battle with the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels. But now, Hollywood Hogan's not having none of it.
Oh, come on!
And a backbreaker.
Viper.
It's almost like it's 1997 again.
Bastard.
You hear the NWO music and another fallen soldier, so to speak, in the AWF. I guess that's how we sign off the program, folks. I've got to apologize on behalf of the AWF.
And ladies and gentlemen, yet again, I do again apologize, because that was a less than desirable way to end the show. And I can only imagine what's leading towards this hellacious event in Detroit, Michigan on September 29th. We will take you to the dark side of the moon. TIF has full reign. And we will see hell come forth. And what the hell? Oh. Ha! Yes! Yes! Christ is real, yes!
And one couldn't say that this wasn't expected.
A stunner! Hulk Hogan
getting the tar beat out of him by AK-170, who also has been vocal about their disdain for Hogan, particularly the man with that bat now being swung over the head of Hogan, Kenneth Kilgore.
The last time Hogan fought here, oh man! Down goes Hogan, it was Mamba Ants and him, and Kenneth said, do not finish him. Leave some for me. And perhaps Hogan thought he could get the confidence to come back here, but AK-170 in the goddamn parking lot with a 1-2-3 count to Hollywood Hogan
and avenging his father on his, and damn right perhaps, Hogan tried to spoil a man's birthday, an AK-170, and checking to see if anyone's coming, and they're gone. Thank you for watching SmackDown. Wow.